Welcome to Everyday Linux User, and welcome to Ubuntu versus Kubuntu, which one is best for the Everyday Linux User. When Ubuntu first started, it was a new kid on the block, and it ran around with his little mate GNOME. And together they tore up the neighborhood, and they took on Microsoft Windows, and they were everything that was cool about computing. It was one of the first Linux distributions that made hardware support usable. It was one of the first distributions that made Linux usable, and it was the best in class when I first started using it. Probably around 2008, 2009 was the first time I really used it. And then, like so many bands across history, there were creative differences. Ubuntu stopped using GNOME, and GNOME went in a different direction. Ubuntu used Unity. They came up with an awful app center. It was absolutely shocking. GNOME, on the other hand, also had its problems, and it was slow and cumbersome. But in the last couple of years, Ubuntu and GNOME reformed, and like many other bands that reform after a long time apart, they have come together and they have produced something quite remarkable. Ubuntu is no longer the punk rocker, it is now the mature citizen of the neighborhood. Everything about Ubuntu seems corporate, it seems like business-like, it seems like it's a distribution that's seriously competing with other operating systems like Windows and Mac OS. It isn't there particularly for fun, but you can have fun with it. Gaming is probably as good on Ubuntu as it is on any Linux distribution there is, and probably as good as you're going to get. If something's going to work, it's going to work on Ubuntu first. GNOME has matured, and Ubuntu has been good for GNOME. It's they go together like peanut butter and jam, and they are what makes Ubuntu good. Now, Ubuntu is now easy to install. It has a really good set of decent default applications with Rhythmbox and Firefox, LibreOffice, etc. It's easy to install applications using the GNOME Software Manager, and snap packages have improved considerably over the last couple of years, and they're on a par with Flatpaks. Now, some snaps aren't available, like if you want a Chrome snap package, then you won't find it, and there's a reason for that, and I'll come to that in another video. So you might want to enable Flatpaks, or you can go and get Chrome from the Google website. Let's move on to Kubuntu. Kubuntu is every bit as solid as Ubuntu in terms of hardware support. The installer, more basic, but it gets the job done for the everyday Linux user. Ubuntu's installer, it has to be said, it caters for a lot more nowadays. It caters for business use as well as personal use. Whereas Kubuntu is still very much geared towards the desktop user. So the installation for Kubuntu hasn't changed all that much, but it's very easy to install. The KDE desktop, as well as the GNOME desktop, they've both matured very, very well. The KDE desktop is now as good as it's ever been. And arguably, I prefer it to GNOME, but that is purely a preference thing. I do like KDE now. I always used to think it was a bit cartoonish, but in the last few years it has matured into something very special indeed. So software on KDE and Kubuntu is very solid. Kdenlive is probably the best video editor there is out there, and I have to say the Discover Software Center is far better than the GNOME one. So it's much easier to enable Flatpaks using the KDE Discover tool, and it's a lot easier to find what you're looking for. Really though, between the two of them, there isn't a huge amount of difference. If you're going between Ubuntu and Kubuntu, we're talking very fine margins. Which desktop environment do you prefer? Is it KDE? Is it GNOME? The installers are slightly different. And support wise, I'd imagine you get slightly more support on Ubuntu than you do Kubuntu, purely because Most of the Ubuntu support will be based around the GNOME, and so if you get a problem with something that's KDE specific, then you're looking towards the Kubuntu developers, and KDE developers may not be quite as solid as the Ubuntu support. So really, I'm gonna cop out and I'm gonna sit on the fence. There's not one better than the other, it's personal preference. Ubuntu is incredibly solid. It's possibly the most mature operating system out there at this moment in time. It's probably, for the everyday Linux user, if you just want to get your work done, it is possibly the best Linux distribution there is out there. And if you consider Linux Mint is there, Ubuntu is now, as I think, it's as good as it's ever been, and it's only getting better. And Kubuntu, I can equally say the same about Kubuntu. It's as good as it's ever been. It's solid, it's dependable. And if you prefer KDE over GNOME, then Kubuntu is a worthwhile choice. So yes, I've copped out. There's not one better than the other. They're both equally as good, and they're both perfectly decent for the everyday Linux user. Don't let other people tell you otherwise. Don't let other people say Ubuntu is just for beginners, or Kubuntu is just for beginners and you should mature into other things like Arch. If you like using Ubuntu, then use it. It is a totally solid, decent distribution. And that's it. That's the end of the video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you next time on Everyday Linux User.